pathways to strengthen our strategies and action plans towards addressing them. Particularly as the year draws to a close with attendant possibility of increase in criminal activities. Within the year, we have been confronted by threats occasioned by the activities of terror elements, bandits, kidnappers, secessionists, and other violent criminals. In dealing with these threats, we have taken operational advantage of the community policing initiative, as well as the optimal deployment of our intelligence capabilities. We also energized Operation Pop Adder, which was initiated to respond to trends of violent crimes across the country in general and the banditry in the northern geopolitical zones in particular. In addition, we launched Operation Restore Peace, which was directed at restoring constitutional order and national cohesion in the southeast and some parts of south-south, where subversive elements operating under the proscribed indigenous people of Biafra, IPO, and Eastern Security Network, ECN, have resorted to armed campaign against symbols of state authority and the citizens. I'm glad to note that we have made significant progress through these strategies in our drive towards attaining our internal security mandate. These achievements could not have been possible without your support, sacrifices, loyalty, and unwavering dedication to duty. As we strive to build on these achievements, we are also initiating certain actions that are directed at addressing specific issues that impact on our professional output. In this regard, in the course of my recent duty tours, I have noticed as well as received complaints on the poor and inhabitable state of most of police barracks. In response to this, the force leadership is currently working with the federal government and the police trust fund, as well as taking full advantage of the private-public partnership window towards redeveloping our barracks and establishing new affordable housing estates for all cadres of our personnel. In addition, we are working at modernizing our police stations across the country, both in terms of architectural design and furnishing and operational protocols. In this regard, we have developed a model police station architectural design, which will be constructed across all the states of the Federation in replacement to the existing outdated police stations, most of which are no longer paid for the purpose it's supposed to serve. The implementation of this project will soon commence, and the initiative is to create purpose-built, friendly, and befitting working environment for police operations in the spirit of community policing, and to start giving practical effect to our vision of modernizing the Nigeria police force. In the interim, I have directed the Provost Marshal to initiate appropriate set of actions toward enforcing barrack rules, restore our facility maintenance culture, and address health and hygiene concerns in our existing barracks and police stations. In compliance with my directive, the first Provost Marshal has submitted an action plan which has been reviewed and approved for immediate implementation. The first Provost Marshal will brief this gathering on the details of the plan in the course of this conference. I must, however, warn that very firm disciplinary actions will henceforth be taken against any officer that fails to comply with the sort of actions being initiated in this regard. Furthermore, as part of our welfare programs, we are in the process of resuscitating the Nigeria Police Force Scholarship Foundation, which was incorporated in the year 2015 for purpose of awarding scholarships to the children of our late officers. In addition, we are on the verge of incorporating the Nigeria Police Insurance Company with with the intent to guarantee seamless insurance services to meet the needs of serving diseased and injured police officers. In recent time, I have been inundated with complaints to the effect that operatives of the Complaint Response Unit have formed a habit of indiscriminately taking over criminal cases from commands and commissions across the country under the guise of investigating allegations of professional misconduct against police personnel. For record purpose, the mandate of CREU is to review and deal with allegations of professional infraction as may be reported by citizens. This mandate does not, I repeat, extend to outright investigation of criminal matters or taking over of cases from commands and commissions. In furtherance to my reform agenda, which is directed at restoring professionalism in the operations of all components of the force, therefore, I have directed that health force operatives of the unit are to limit themselves to their mandate of investigating only allegations of professional infraction against police personnel. In line with this, on no account should the unit take over case files, and on no account should zone or state or commission transfer any criminal matter to the unit. Furthermore, I am still receiving complaints touching on gross professionalism misconduct by operatives on patrol duties as well as others involved in criminal investigations or surveillance duties. These complaints often touch on incivility to members of the public, extortion, and other forms of discreditable conduct. These professional infractions utterly negate our policing values, just as they negatively impact on our drive to smoothen our partnership with the citizens. Accordingly, I wish to use this opportunity of this conference to reinforce the content of my recent signal that you charge your monitoring units and escorts to commence an enforcement drive that will identify the incorrigible officers involved in these unethical conducts. The IGP monitoring unit, the escort section in the First Criminal Investigation Department, as well as the provost marshal, are also directed to immediately deploy their personnel across all commands with a view to giving effect to this order. Stand disciplinary measures will be initiated against any personnel arrested in the course of this enforcement drive. My charge to you is to return to your command and evolve strategies and implementation plans towards guaranteeing a stable security order. Accordingly, you are all to submit your end of year security operational plans to my office through the Deputy Inspector General of Police in charge of operations latest by the end of this month. To complement your efforts, I can assure you that we shall soon launch and deploy new fleet of patrol vehicles and other operational assets which are being procured through the intervention of the Police Trust Fund and our budgetary allocations. On this note, I welcome you to this conference and look forward to the professionally rewarding outcome and discussion with a view to understanding and appreciating our situation and how to deploy our human resources and tactical assets to maintain law and order in this country, which is our main mandate.